So this Adobe After Effects effect pays me every single month, and it now lives within Adobe Premiere Pro. We actually built a visual effect from scratch and packaged it in a way that makes it easier for other editors to use. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simplified version of that same effect and how these kinds of digital tools can lead to real income. We call this effect E-Prism, and it's a lens distortion effect that adds cinematic refraction to your footage. This layered distortion gives it a sense of depth and stylized fragmentation. We built it using After Effects and then exported it as a drag and drop motion graphics template, also called a MOGRT. This means that Premiere Pro users can now use it directly in their timelines without ever needing to open After Effects. You just drop it in, tweak a few sliders, and go. Right now, there is a massive market for creative tools that live within Premiere Pro. Thousands of editors want advanced visuals, but either don't have the time or aren't comfortable with diving into After Effects. And this opens up a great opportunity. If you can build something in After Effects, you can package it for Premiere Pro and make it sellable. This is exactly what we did with E-Prism, and literally anyone else can do this. It doesn't matter what country you're in, what your income level is, or how big your audience is. You can build a digital product once and then sell it forever. You can sell it directly to your audience, partner with someone who already has an audience, or list it in an established marketplace. So now it's time to go inside of After Effects, where I'm going to show you how to build a simplified version of E-Prism. Now, open up After Effects. First, you're going to drop your main footage into a new comp. That's short for composition. Then create an adjustment layer. On that adjustment layer, draw two triangle-shaped masks. Place one on the left, and then one on the right of the frame. Feather each mask by about 80 pixels so that they blend softly. Now apply the transform effect to the adjustment layer. Increase the scale to around 120% for each triangle area. Then maybe slightly offset the position and reduce the opacity inside the transform effect if you want to add some variation between the two zones. This creates a refracted magnification effect, kind of like light bending through shards of glass. Once you're happy with the look, open up the essential graphics panel. Choose your comp as the master and then drag the properties you want your users to control, like scale, position, and opacity, into the panel. Rename them something clear, like left prism zoom or right prism blend. Then export the MOGRT out of After Effects. Now it's time to go into Premiere Pro. Once you're in Premiere Pro, open up the graphics templates panel. After that, you can actually see the MOGRT that you just made in After Effects exported automatically into that panel. Now, drag it into your Premiere Pro timeline, and you'll notice that your custom controls that you made in After Effects will show up instantly. It's pretty cool. MOGRTs are one of the easiest ways to turn your After Effects skills into something scalable, and I guarantee that there are probably multiple MOGRT ideas hiding in the projects that you've already done. Guys, if you want to grab our full E-Prism pack, I'm talking about the complete one that we usually sell, you can actually get it for free in the link below. I really hope this tutorial inspired you. Now I challenge you to now go make a MOGRT yourself, something that's going to help someone else make even better work.